Hello everyone, welcome back to supplychainway.com. I am Elvis Lazarus. In this video, we are going to discuss on a business case on food delivery supply chain optimization. So the industry is service, the category is food delivery. Complexity, I would rate it as 6 out of 10. So about the business, the business name is FoodAZ, and that's the way we pronounce it, FoodAZ. So FoodAZ is a food delivery app. It is a startup based out of Dubai and operates as a marketplace. So the customers would place order through the mobile application and the order is fulfilled by the FoodAZ. So the operation is going to be, once you receive the order, the food delivery executive would go pick up the food from the restaurant and get that delivered to the customer. Now the startup is building their mobile application and they are in the phase of writing the FRDs, which is functional requirement definitions, and the blueprint for the application. So the business case, what we have here is, FoodAZ has given you the structure of the model, which would be the backend in the mobile application, and it is as follows. So it is a 5-stage model. So the stage one is about building the masters and the data structuring. So collection of the basic data, which goes as an input into the logistics planner, which is in the stage two. And when initiating this model, that is the pre-launch phase, the model will be fed with all the input data, and the model starts validating the initial data and then refine them with actual data. In the sense, the day we start, we put in all the initial data, and basis that assumptions, the model would start running. Then it will have the intelligence to refine on its own based on the actual performance data. Stage 2 is the logistics planner, which uses all the key inputs, assumptions, sales and operations plan, resource availability, cycle times, resource efficiency, etc., to do the logistics planning and daily scheduling and routing. It would also do the forecasting based on the S&OP. Stage 3 is the supply chain optimization phase, wherein the data is further drilled down to optimize the resources. So this supply chain optimizer is not a separate system. It actually resides within the logistics planner. So logistics planner will take in all the input from the masters and the data structure, what you do in stage one, and gives the output. So that is how the data flow would be. So the most complex algorithms run here to optimize the resources with all the constraints. SCM optimizer will do the optimization between all the counterbalancing supply chain activities. And stage four is scenario builder, which works on creating various scenarios to understand the dynamics of the business. It is basically a simulator, the most exciting phase, wherein we give multiple scenarios and the model supports with the operational decisions and insights on financials. So a scenario could be like this: what if my volumes increase by 5x? So similar to this, you can post a scenario and the model has a capability to give back the operational decisions we need to take around that, and also a very important thing is insights on the financials. Most of the knowledge in this industry, standards and the key learning are added as algorithms in backend, such that the model uses that to deliver the key support on supply chain decisions. Stage 5 describes the type of process controls and MAS and reports and dashboards to be maintained to continuously monitor and improve the operations to achieve cost and service level optimization. Okay, so this explains the backend of the mobile application, which is the core engine within this mobile application. Now what you need to do, the action plan is, you are the supply chain functional consultant. You need to complete the blueprint and submit the same as a report. So what should be part of the blueprint? List down all the master data required for this mobile application. List down all the input to the logistics planner and the output from the planner. Key factors to be considered during the supply chain optimization. As I said before, this optimizer is residing within the logistics planner. So you have to tell what are all the factors to be considered during the supply chain optimization. establish key relationship between the input parameters and the output. For example, if you are considering traffic as one of the input parameter through an indicator or some values, the output is, for example, the number of field executives required. You need to establish what is the relationship between that input parameter and the output. So you need to do this for all the input parameters and the output. And keep in mind, one input parameter could impact multiple output. Top level reports to be generated. So these are the things to be completed as an action plan and to be submitted. If you have any clarifications on the case in the terms I have used or the business model or in terms of the expectations, please feel free to leave a note in the comment section and I would be glad to explain that for you. If you want to complete the case and submit back to me, you can send your completed report to info@supplychainway.com. An expert would review that and give you the guidance in terms of whether you've completed it well or anything else to be done. And all the very best to you in solving this business case.